Hello children, good morning. Today I will continue the same chapter. So today first I want to give you the definition of hemocelomate and eucelomate. So hemocelomate, it is found in early stages of the development of the young one. But after some time or later it is completely obliterated by the blastocoel or the cavity of the blastula, and which is filled with the hemocyanin. I think children you know we have hemoglobin in our blood, so our blood is red in color, but the arthropods mainly their blood is light blue in color due to the presence of hemocyanin. So children, you can understand these are having hemocelomate or hemocelomic cavity. So it is obliterated by the fluid filled with hemocyanin. So this is known as hemocelomate. Next one, eucelomate. It is having coelom which should be covered, or it is covered with the mesodermal cells. Mesodermal cells, that means mesoderm is fully developed, and these cells are called as peritoneum. So those organism have development with the ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, and mesoderm is fully developed with the peritoneum wall, and they have enteron or true body cavity, so they are also termed as enterocoelom. Now after this coelomic cavity we will go for the segmentation. As the name suggests you, that segmentation, how the body is divided or body is not divided. So segmentation having metamer, that means body is divided, and next is pseudo segmentation, that means false segmentation, that means it looks like segments are there but there is no proper segmentation. Just for the example you can think about the earthworm. You can see the rings around it, around their body, by which we can understand that there is no segmentation throughout their body, but those who don't know, they will think that earthworm are having some segmentation. So this is pseudo segmentation. Now pseudo segmentation is of two types, metameric and non-metameric. Metameric means those who are having all the segments in their body in a proper shape, size with the organelles, and their number remains same throughout their species or everywhere throughout their life. These are known as metameric segmentation. And non-metameric, as the name indicates, they are having separation or metamerism, but they are not equal in all the bodies. Simply, just like the plant, when we cut the plant or apical bud of the plant, it will grow into length. So they are also having non-metameric segmentation, that means they continue to join their segments in their body as per their perseverance, or that means according to their habitat, where they are growing, where they are living, and they can continue it or not. So this is non-metameric segmentation. Now children, we are coming to the cephalization. Word cephalization, if you have seen prawn have head, neck, both are joined, but you do not have head and neck joined. See, so this is the cephalization, that means inside the mother's womb, when children or when young one starts to grow, they have the formation of head. Formation of head when takes place very smoothly, easily, and it is totally divided from the neck or separated from the neck. So these are having separate head. Otherwise, head and neck will be fused. This is known as cephalothorax, and process of formation of head is known as cephalization. So cephalization takes place while growing in all the organisms, then only we can identify about that this embryo will grow into the human being, this embryo will grow into the horse, this embryo will grow into the donkey, and this embryo will grow into the cat. Only after civilization only we can, or doctors can, understand the process of civilization and how the organism will grow. Now it was the fifth point. Now come to the sixth point about the skeleton. Skeleton, as you know, that we have skeleton and we have bones, but these bones are present inside the body. So this is termed as endoskeleton. That means skeleton, if present inside the body, is endoskeleton, and if the skeleton present outside the body, it is exoskeleton, as we are getting in fishes, scales are there. So this is the example of exoskeleton. So what is the skeleton? Skeleton means which supports our body to be its own position. Maybe it is erect, maybe it is parallel to the ground as in the fishes, maybe elsewhere, maybe any type, but should be its in proper position. This is known as skeleton. So human being have endoskeleton, frogs have endoskeleton, fishes, that is exoskeleton, have scales, birds have exoskeleton, that is wings, but birds have bones also. So this is the example of exo and endoskeleton. Now we will come to the next point, body temperature. As children, you already studied in 9th and 6th, 7th also. The animals are of two types. Some are cold-blooded, some are warm-blooded. Now children, you don't use that cold-blooded and warm-blooded. You have to use cold-blooded animal, that is poikilothermal. Those who can change their temperature according to their habitat. So they are called as poikilothermal body or poikilothermic animal. Next one, those who are warm-blooded, that means they can maintain their body temperature instead whether the atmosphere having low temperature or whether the atmosphere is having less high temperature, but their body temperature they can maintain, or they will maintain. So they are known as homeothermal organism. Now children, we will come to the different types of classification. Now classification means all these words I taught you in this chapter, all these words will be used in the classification of animals. So children, while we are using these animals, while we seeing these animals in the laboratories, then we will discuss about the classification. But children, all the names you should remember it. What is the meaning of exoskeleton? What is the meaning of cephalization? What is the meaning of diploblastic? What is the meaning of triploblastic? And what is the meaning of different words or different terms? Then you can study classification very easily. Children, now I will tell you about these two words also, diploblastic and triploblastic. So diploblastic, as the name suggests, animals will grow with the help of two germ layers, that is ectoderm and endoderm. And triploblastic means animals will grow with the three germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, as I studied earlier. So these are the triploblastic animal. So children, for today it is over, and all the terms you should learn thoroughly so you can understand about the classification. Over for today, it is over. Thank you, children.